My name is Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, we're going to explore the similarities and differences between dissociation and ionization. By definition, dissociation is a process associated with ionic compounds because they originally contain ions, and those ions, when dissolved in water, will dissociate. So they had ionic components, and the ionic components are separated. That is the process of dissociation. When we have an ionic compound, the dissociation reaction is written simply as, in the case of sodium carbonate, when it dissolves in water, it goes from the solid ionic compound to the aqueous ions. And in that case, there will be two sodium ions that are surrounded by water in the solution. There are two sodium ions because there was a subscript of 2 on the sodium in sodium carbonate, so that will go in the front. Sodium is a group 1 metal, so it will have a plus 1 charge. 2 sodium plus 1 ions, plus the carbonate ion has a 2 minus charge, and that polyatomic ion will be surrounded by water in the solution. We will do the same thing if we have other ionic compounds, simply separated out into ionic components. And unless it is a polyatomic ion, in which case it stays together, the subscript associated with any of the elements will become a stoichiometric coefficient in front of the ion on the right side of the equation. When it comes to molecular compounds, it really depends on what they are. When we have a strong acid, and that will be one of 7 acids, they will undergo ionization reaction. In the ionization process, the hydrogen will separate in the polar bond, and it will become a hydrogen ion that will be surrounded by water, and it will become the oxonium ion. The remaining polyatomic anion or monoanion is going to maintain the original charge, and it will be surrounded by water. In both instances, both the dissociation and the ionization process, the result is the formation of ions in solution. The only difference is that for dissociation, we're starting with ions in an ionic compound, and for ionization, we're starting with a molecular compound. For molecular compounds, there are layers of possibilities. If we have a strong acid that is a molecular compound, then it will fully ionize in water, completely separating into hydrogen ions and anions. If we have a weak acid, it will also ionize, but not completely, probably about up to 5% ionization. One example that may come up frequently in the general chemistry lab is acetic acid. That one is a weak acid, and it will partially ionize in water. And to illustrate that, the separation of the hydrogen ion from the acetic acid is only partial, we're going to use this double-sided arrow. For weak bases that are also molecular compound, the same process applies. There will be an ionization process occurring. And in this case, the ammonia will become the ammonium ion. Because this is a partial ionization step, we also indicated with the use of the double-sided arrow. If we have polar molecular compounds that dissolve in water but do not ionize or release any kind of ions in solution, we keep them together. In the case of methanol dissolved in water, or methanol mixing with water, we don't expect any ionic components to form. So in that case, we will say it is a polar molecular compound that dissolves in water, but does not ionize.